ages, casting centuries aside, or a hurried, brief recital, just a 30-minute ride. Whether bright or melancholy, rough and ready, finely spun, whether with a thousand players or lonely cast of one. Every story, new or ancient, bagatelle or work of art, all our tales of human failing, all our tales of love at home. This is a story of a love that flourished in a time of hate, of a lover's no tyranny could separate. Love set into motion on the Nile shore, destiny ignited by an act of war. Egypt saw the mighty river as its very heart and soul, the source of life for all of her people that only Egypt could control. Destruction of her southern neighbor justified.
Riverbed, Captain.
Your country's at war, and you go wandering along the Nile's edge? You must have a burning desire to see Egypt. Put her in chains. Have you finished the maps?
Yes, sir, I have.
Good work. But this is wrong. From the mast, it looked like it curved to the north, like this.
Hey, my sword! My sword!
Release them!
Hand it over! Now!
You took us from Nubia, and now you say we belong to you, yes?
Yes.
Well, I took this soldier from your ranks, so by your own logic, he belongs to me. Now let them go.
Throw her in the river.
No. I have a better plan for her.
Don't!
You don't want me to remove your shackles?
Oh, yes.
They'll only get in the way. Very impressive up there. I should enlist you in my army, make you my lieutenant.
Are you mocking me, Captain?
No. Admiring you. Do you know what's going to happen now? You're going to scrub the filth of battle from my skin. It's been a long time since I felt clean. You're much better with a sword than you are with a sponge.
I wish I had a sword now.
There's mine. Help yourself. Who taught you to use a weapon?
My father.
Is it because he knows Nubian men can't protect their women? You're not finished.
Yes, I am.
You enjoy living dangerously, don't you?
About as much as I enjoy washing your filthy Egyptian skin.
You.
No. You know nothing about me, and care even less. How could you understand our emptiness? You've plundered our wisdom, our knowledge, our wealth. In bleeding us dry, you long for our spirit, but that you will never possess. The past is now another land, far beyond my reach.
Captain, we're ready to dock.
What? No, please! Leave them off!
You're a slave now. And if you want to survive, you better remember it.
Marib! You have the wine?
You have the gold?
Marib!
Master! I'm so glad you're home!
Have you kept my house in order?
Ah, yes. Well, except for a few casks of wine which have mysteriously disappeared.
Again?
Here you are, my son, home at last. Step aside, Marib.
Ah, yes, Chief Minister Zolzer, beloved by the gods, the people, and himself.
Careful, boy, or I'll have you.
It's good to see you, Father.
Radames, you were gone so long I was beginning to worry. You weren't injured in battle.
No.
I kept telling the princess no man can best you with a sword.
No man got the best of me, Father. Though a certain woman might have.
Really?
Listen, beyond the fifth cataract, the Nile heads directly towards Khartoum.
Then we can attack the city by water. Excellent. And you recorded the landscape.
With the maps we made, an illiterate foot soldier could find his way through Nubia.
And you've brought home captives. Good, good. Take them to the copper mines. We can't seem to keep them alive down there.
No, stop. Not this one. I'm going to need a gift for the princess.
Yes. She'll be expecting something.
Take them to the palace groundskeeper. They can help with the harvest. They're all women. They wouldn't last a day underground.
As you wish. they're your slaves.
Thank you.
Give me your hands, Aida.
Your name is Aida?
Merib. No, I'm going to remove these. But know that if you dare try to escape, I'll come after you myself.
You flatter me, Captain. You don't look like a man who would chase after any woman.
I'll make an exception for you. Merib, take her to the princess with my compliments.
Yes, Captain.
Radames, you've been gone 6 months. I really think a personal appearance is in order.
Yes, in good time, Father. But you and the princess should know that as soon as my crew is rested, I'm setting out again.
Radames, you can't. Egypt needs you now. Pharaoh was not the powerful leader he was when you left.
While you've been away cavorting, matters here have moved apace. Now I need you home supporting all the plans I've put in place. First of all, this means your wedding. You'll recall your future bride. For the way that Pharaoh's heading, time's no longer on our side. According to the hawk god Horus, our most regal invalid is not that much longer for us. Build another pyramid.
You mean the Pharaoh's fallen ill? Is it serious?
I'm afraid so.
I must go to him.
Yes, that will bring him some comfort. I will see you tonight at the banquet, Captain.
There are many who'll be tearful as our leader fades away. But our architects are cheerful, and each dog must have its day. If our country is to flourish, then my son must take the lead. Be our inspiration, nourish all our hopes, our dreams, our creed. Soon our monarch will have filled the tomb, just like his fathers did. Summit Egypt's greatest builder, be another pyramid.
Build it, build it, another pyramid.
There will be a time for mourning, but for now put plans on hold. For I give the nation warning, that before the corpse is cold, we'll extend fair Egypt's power, Egypt's glory, strength, and style. We shall have our finest hour, far beyond the mighty Nile. He must have a wall that's red mine, any standards floor to lit. Put 5,000 slaves on standby, build another.
Someone has been telling the Pharaoh about our private meetings. Traitor! He has become a liability. Ah, you extracted more arsenic. Who would have thought that the copper mines would yield such an abundant supply? Put some in Pharaoh's wine tonight at the banquet. Again, only a few drops. We don't want him dying just yet.
He must have fought this grand by. Standards floor to lid. Put 5,000 slaves on standby. Build another pyramid.
Well, now you look like a handmaiden, but at least the captain saw that you're special.
What that man sees and understands could be etched on a grain of sand.
That may be, but Captain Radames did save you and all the other women from the copper mines.
That was surprising, and decent of him.
When I was 10, Captain Radames saved me from being beaten to death by the palace guard. He promised he'd look after me from then on. He's kept that promise. Look, I know what you're thinking. That I've become one of them. but I'm still Nubian. I'll always be Nubian.
Of course.
I grew up in your hometown, at least began to grow. I hadn't got to my first shave before the body blow. Egyptians in the courtyard, my family in chains. You witnessed our abduction, which possibly explains how I know you, how I know you. Before that fateful morning, my family enjoyed a privileged existence. For my father was employed as advisor to the king, no less, which surely rings a bell. For as you are his daughter, you probably can tell how I know you. Yes, I know you.
I know too much, and what you say is better left unknown. Now I'm just a slave like you. Our lives are not our own.
I never have abandoned, and nor I think could you. That spark of hope for freedom, no terror can subdue.
My only hope is silence. You've never seen my face.
No, you remain a princess in any time or place.
You don't know me.
Yes, I know you.
You don't know me.
How I know you. How I know you. Princess.
Mirab, you must treat me like any other slave. If the Egyptians knew I was the daughter of the Nubian king,
they would kill you, but our people will keep your secret.
No. You must not tell anyone who I am. From now on, I am nothing but a gift from an Egyptian captain to his princess.
Just so you know, Amneris is more to that, Radames. She's his betrothed.
He's to be married? When?
The day his ship sinks and the royal builders refuse to put him another. Come, let's get you to the princess.
It is such hard work maintaining perfection. But worth the effort, don't you think? Really? Perfect? Well, if I'm perfect, then maybe one of you can explain why Radames, the man destined to be my one and only, is neglecting me. He spent time with my father, and I hear he spent time with his father. In fact, he's probably chummed it up with every withered old man in Egypt. So clearly, the thought of visiting a young and beautiful, charming princess with fabulous hair leaves him cold.
Princess of Neris, first in beauty, wisdom, and accessories. Captain Radames has not forgotten you. He knows you'll be at the banquet tonight in all your extravagant finery, and he can hardly wait. But for now, he sends you this gift.
A handmaiden? I don't need another handmaiden!
Well, does this gift have a name?
Aida.
Did you just speak?
My name is Aida, princess. And I thought you...
How dare you!
You do not lower your eyes. You do not tremble. Are you not afraid of me? Would it please you if I were?
Not so much.
Then I am doing as you please.
Well, that's true.
Now you were saying something about...
Captain Radames.
And what do you know of the captain?
Only that he is well. He suffered no injuries in battle. I thought you might wish to know that.
I did. I've been so... You're very astute, aren't you, Aida?
Only on occasion. My true talent lies within a needle. And if you would allow me, princess, I will make you a robe in a shade closer to that of your eyes. There's a dyeing process I use which makes fabric glow. It's a secret that was passed down from the handmaidens of Queen Nefertiti.
A slave who knows her fabric! I'm keeping her. Oh, Radames. He really, really knows me. Merib, show her to the sewing room! Go, faster! All right, ladies! Ah! Let's polish this gem! In life, one has to face a huge assortment of nauseating fads and good advice. There's health and fitness, diet and deportment, and other pointless forms of sacrifice. Conversation, wit, I am a doubter. Manners, charm, they're no way to impress. So forget the inner me, observe the outer. I am what I wear and how I dress. Oh, now I believe in looking like my time on earth is cooking. Whether polka dotted, striped, or even checked. With some glamour guaranteeing, every fiber of my being is displayed to quite remarkable effect. From your cradle by your trousseau to your deathbed, you're on view. So never compromise, accept no substitute. I would rather wear a barrel than conservative apparel. For dress has always been my strongest suit.
Woo!
Princess pleased with my gift?
Ah, yes. Aida managed to make herself indispensable in record time.
I'm not surprised. Did she tell you anything about herself? Because I've never met a woman like her before, and I can't help but wonder if there's...
No, nothing. She said nothing.
Lovely.
Thank you.
Is this the latest fashion?
It is now. So, your expedition went well?
Yes. We got well past Aswan, into territory where no Egyptian has ever set foot.
Really? That sounds so exotic. Maybe next time I'll go with you.
If you like, Princess. We sleep with sand mites, live on dried monkey meat, and this time the water was so tainted, we vomited for days.
Then again, I'm pretty busy, so...
Princess, the word of your arrival has spread through the Nubian camps. People cannot wait to see you. Welcome. Welcome. Merib!
Okay, so I told one person. Princess, your people needed to know.
Captain! to your successful journey. Thanks to the routes you have discovered, our troops will now be able to attack Nubia with overwhelming force. The gods willing, this long war shall soon end with Egypt's complete and final victory. Amneris, shall I continue?
Whatever you think is best, Father.
Radames, you came to me this morning with a request to set out on another journey. However, I have a more important mission for you. Although it means you may never leave Egyptian soil again, I believe this will be a joyous assignment, one I would only trust to a man I've long regarded as one of my own family.
It has been my privilege to serve you, Your Majesty.
As you all know, the captain and my daughter have been betrothed for 9 years now. Long enough, I say. I want to see her and our nation happily settled before I leave this world. Therefore, in 7 days' time, Radames, son of Zoser, will wed the Princess Amneris. The son of Isis has spoken.
A toast to the bridegroom. If I'd known such an awkward young girl could turn into such a stunning young woman, I would have offered her for myself.
It's not too late.
What do you mean? I thought you loved Amneris.
Of course I do. We grew up together.
Then what is it? Radames, I've spent years working towards this day, and you're not going to ruin it for yourself or me. Welcome to your new life, son.
Nothing is an accident. We are free to have it all. We are what we want to be. It's in ourselves to rise or fall. This is easy to believe when distant places call to me. It's harder from the palace yard. Fortune favors the free. Stop. Come back.
Yes, Captain.
Where are you from?
Aida. It's a village near
the second cataract. Yes. The river's an entirely different color there.
No, it's an entirely different color here.
Fair enough.
My father and I used to spend the days sailing the Nile. He'd let me choose the course, and sometimes I'd run us aground on purpose, whenever I wanted to see something on shore.
Did you ever sail north?
No. My father felt the first cataract. Being so close to the border of Egypt was too dangerous a place to take me.
But there are no Egyptians at the first cataract. Only these tiny grassy islands. And the sunlight, it's different there. Here, it is direct, harsh. But there, it shimmers. It's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
Of course. It's Nubia. I'd like to see that part of my country.
To sail away to half-discovered places, to see the secrets so few eyes have seen, to see moments of enchantment on our faces, the moments when we smile and those between.
Are you talking about Nubia now?
Yes. In a way.
If I could leave this place and I'd go sailing to corners of my land where there would be sweet southern winds with liberty prevailing. The beauty so majestic and so free.
I will take you sailing. South. You could be my guide.
Will you let me steer?
Will you run us aground?
Oh, yes. Wherever there are no people,
I'll jump out of the boat, kick off my sandals, and run. And there will be no one there to scold me and to tell me to behave like a... to behave.
There'd be no ties of time and space to bind me.
And no horizon I could not pursue.
I'd leave the world's misfortunes far behind me.
I'll put my faith and trust in something new. But why did I tell you this? A stranger I just met.
A woman whom I hardly know at all and will forget. A journey we can only dream of.
Enchantment passing through. And how is it I say these things so easily to you?
This is meaningless. I'll never take you sailing. I'm never going to leave Egypt again. Instead, I'll sit on the throne and send other men off on their expeditions.
You talk as though you're enslaved.
Not with chains, maybe, but with a marriage promise.
Oh, forced to marry a princess. I know you want to go to lands where people have been living for centuries and say that you discovered them. But instead you're being thrust onto the Pharaoh's throne. It is a great tragedy.
You go too far.
No, you go too far. If you don't like your fate, change it. You are your own master. I don't see any shackles on you. So don't expect any pity or understanding from this humble palace slave.
Stop. I command you to stop. But why did I tell her this? A stranger I just met. A woman whom I hardly know at all and should forget. Anonymous and gone tomorrow. Enchantment passing through. And all I've done is tell her things that she already knew. She knew. She knew.
Here. Let me. How is your father? I don't understand it. This illness of his came on so suddenly. Weeks ago he was healthy. And the court physicians? They have no idea what it is. Well, it was a magnificent feast, wasn't it?
Yes, princess.
Oh, there is so much to do to get ready for the wedding ceremony. Oh, from the bronzed entry statue of me to the centerpieces of lilies and roses arranged to look like me.
It must be difficult.
What, planning a wedding?
No, being a princess.
Oh, you have no idea. Oh.
The responsibilities are overwhelming. Your people must expect so much.
They want a goddess, and I'm just human.
I may leave a great impression as I race through a succession of the latest, craziest chase, the newest fad. I feel better when beguiling, find that fashion keeps me smiling. But in my heart, I know it's rather sad that a life of great potential is dismissed, inconsequential, and only ever seen as being cute. out. So I'll flutter to deceive.
Oh, no, no, you must believe that one day you're bound to find a stronger suit.
Radames! This is my bedchamber! You can't just... You know you shouldn't. Aida, leave!
No.
No?
Stay. Is that your bed in there?
Silk covered and fat with feathers.
Why don't you go in? I'll join you in a moment. You think you can talk to me like that? Scold me like a shrew, then walk away? You forget that I can have you carried off to the copper mines.
And you forget that I'm her property now, not yours.
It doesn't matter. Because I now know that you are right. What?
I'm shocked. Even in enlightened Nubia, no one ever hears a man admit he's wrong. Radames.
I'll be right in, princess. Aida, look, I was wrong. I've been selfish. If the Pharaoh does not recover, Egypt's going to need a new leader. A strong leader. And I don't think that that's Amneris.
Radames, I'm... waiting. You should go to her.
Were you a noble woman before you were captured?
What does it matter? There's nothing noble about me now.
You're wrong. You are noble. And courageous. Very few of us dare to speak so honestly. And considering you're a slave...
Yes! We mustn't ever forget that I'm a slave.
I can't take back the past. And even if I could, I'm not sure I'd want to. Aida.
Radames! You barged into my bedchambers, and now you keep me waiting while you stand here talking to her? Why?
I'm sorry, I didn't realize
that... What didn't you realize? That I might need some attention? Oh, that I would like to spend some time with you before our wedding day? Oh, that for just one moment, I would like to feel more important than your adventures off exploring new territories. Was it something I said? When we were younger, we understood each other so well. Now he's a mystery to me.
Aida, there you are. Will you come with me, please?
Where?
The Nubian camp. Look, everybody knows I'm the one who can get things. And our people, well, they've asked me to bring them you.
Why? So they can see a reckless fool dressed as a servant? That is what I am, Marib. My father told me not to leave the boundaries of the village, but I could not be so constrained. I took the Hepka and the others up the river. I just had to see the countryside. And that is where the Egyptians captured us. I deserve this. And the people deserve a leader who thinks of them, not of her own selfish pleasures.
Aida. The Nubians want their princess.
It's knowing what they want of me that scares me. It's knowing, having followed, I must lead. It's knowing that each person there compares me to those in a past who might now succeed. But how can whatever I do for them now Be enough.
Aida, Aida, all we ask of you is a lifetime of service, wisdom, courage. To ask more would be selfish, but nothing less will do. Aida.
should be golden, your robe should be perfect, instead of this ragged concoction of thread. But may you be moved by its desperate beauty to give us new life. For we'd rather be dead than live in the squalor and shame of a slave. To the dance, to the dance!
Aida, Aida, all we ask of you,
all we ask is a lifetime of service, wisdom, courage.
To ask more would be selfish, but nothing less will do.
Watching me again. All week your eyes have been on me.
I don't know what you mean.
You think you can claim your freedom just because you've gained my attention? You're beautiful, but I'm not easily led.
If I've looked in your direction, it was only to see if your chalice needed filling.
I have no chalice now, and yet, you're looking.
Excuse me, Captain, but I have linen to wash.
Stop. I do not excuse you.
You wanted something from me?
Oh, yes. I would like to help you. Tell me how.
Help my people?
I want to help you.
I am my people, and I cannot continue to live in the comfort of the palace while my countrymen are dying. You want my affection, Captain?
I could have your affection right here if I commanded it. I want to know if you feel something for me, aside from contempt.
I don't know.
Then let's find out.
Aida, I just saw! Aida, Amneris requests your presence. The princess, your betrothed.
Knew all the answers. I stood on certain ground. A picture of true happiness. Confidence so effortless. No brighter could be found.
Oh no.
I never asked the questions that trouble me today. I knew all there was to know. Love worn lightly, put on show. My conquest on display.
I can't believe he's changing.
And who'd have thought that confidence could die?
Oh no.
Not me.
Not me.
Not me.
Not me.
That all I took for granted was a lie.
Oh no.
Not me.
Not me.
Not me.
Not me.
Who'd have guessed I'd throw my world away to be with someone I'm afraid will say not me.
This can never be.
Not me.
He's in love, but he's not the only one who'll be changed.
Oh, this would look lovely on you. I'll say this for you Egyptians. Your thread count is amazing. Why hasn't Radames come to see me again? We're to be married in 3 days, and yet... Aida, I must make things right with him.
I shall not envy lovers, nor long for what they share. An empty room is merciless. Don't be surprised if I confess I need some comfort there. And who'd have thought our love could be so good? Not me, not me. And show me things I never understood. Not me.
Where did you get that?
From the Egyptian captain. He's giving away everything he owns, and he's giving it all to us.
Who'd have guessed he'd throw his world away to be with someone till his dying day? Not me. Not me. And who'd have thought our love could be so good? Until the dying day. Not me.
Never be.
Not me.
Look. He's preparing to move into the palace. So whatever doubts he had from the other night must be gone. Oh, but you stay, Aida. Apologize for me.
I can't.
You can. You always say the right thing. I never do.
Princess, please don't make me.
I would never make you. But I'm asking you, as my friend.
Thank you.
It was nothing. Actually, it was everything. But that doesn't matter.
Captain, I am here to tell you that the princess is sorry for what she said the other night. She would like you to know that...
Aida.
You are betrothed to my mistress.
It was arranged by my father, and it will be unarranged by me.
You could raid another country tomorrow and rebuild your fortune. Radames, you're an Egyptian. Nothing will ever change that fact. I don't know why you're bothered to do this.
Don't you? We all lead such elaborate lives, wild ambitions in our sights. How in a fair of the heart survives days apart and hurried nights seems quite unbelievable to me. I don't want to live like that. Seems quite unbelievable to me. I don't want to love like that. I just want our time to be slower and gentler, wiser, free. We all live in extravagant times, playing games we can't all win. Unintended emotional crimes take some out, take others in. I'm so tired of all we're going through. I don't want to live like that. I'm so tired of all we're going through. I don't want to love like that. I just wanna be with you now and forever. Peaceful, true. This may not be the moment to tell you face to face, but I could wait forever for the perfect time and place. We all lead such elaborate lives. We don't know whose words are true. Strangers, lovers, husbands, wives. Hard to know who's loving who.
Too many choices tear us apart. I don't want to live like that.
Too many choices tear us apart. I don't want to love like that. I just wanna touch your heart. May this confession be the start. I want to be a new man for you, Aida. Reborn, cleansed of my past sins.
What is it?
My armies have returned. Pharaoh will be expecting me tonight at the victory celebration. Go back to the palace. You'll be safe there. Wait. Take my amulet. If anybody bothers you, show them this, and they'll let you pass.
I love you.
I heard that. Say it again. I command you.
Captain!
I heard the drums.
Oh, we've captured the Nubian king.
The king? You've captured him alive.
Yes, Captain.
Find out which men are responsible for this. See that they receive the highest of honors. Tell the others I'm on my way.
Yes, Captain.
Aida, our countries are at war. I can't change that.
But he's my king.
Deal with these.
Princess! Say it's not true.
I saw them drag our king through the streets with my own eyes.
I heard they already executed him.
And they're carrying his head throughout the city.
No!
Amenasru of Nubia's alive. I saw him taken to the prison.
But it's only a matter of time before the Egyptians slaughter him.
I've always imagined your father march upon Egyptian triumph. But now we have no hope. When the king dies, so does Nubia.
No! Nubia will never die. Whether we are enslaved or whether we are far from our native soil, Nubia lives in our hearts. And therefore, it lives.
Take me in my dreams, recurring, cheerful as a childhood dance, into one more taste of freedom, one more longing backward glance. In the sway of somber music, I shall never, never understand. Let me slip in into the sweeter chorus of that other land. The gods love Nubia, the beautiful, the golden, the radiant, the fertile, the gentle and the blessed. The pain of Nubia is only of the moment, the desolate, the suffering, the plundered, the oppressed. The glorious creation, their songs roll sweetly across the harvest plain. The tears of Nubia, a passing aberration, they wash into the river and are never cried again. Still its heart, the fall of Nubia, ephemeral and fleeting, the spirit always burning, though the flesh is torn apart. romantic leads. There are times when I imagine I'm not always on his mind. He's not thinking what I'm thinking, always half a step behind, always half a step behind.
Can't you tell? Just look at me. Half ecstatic, half dejected. All in all, I'm all at sea. Easy terms I thought I wanted fill me now with chilling dread. You could never know the chaos of a life turned on its head. Of a life turned on its head. Oh, 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 oh.
I'm certain that I love him, but a love can be misplaced. Have I compromised my people in my passion and my haste? I could be his life companion anywhere but where we are. Am I leader? Am I traitor? Did I take a step too far? Did I take a step too far? Change, he doesn't show
I'm
me
every kind of trouble.
More affection than
he can love you tell? Just look at
or
me.
To love can be
half ecstatic, half projected. All in all, I'm all at sea.
Can I touch when I get
easy terms I thought I wanted.
I'm not always on his mind. Anywhere but where I am.
Never know the chaos.
Am I trying?
Can
I take a step behind?
But be quick about it.
Father?
Aida! I knew you would survive. That I trained my daughter well. At least, I would not allow myself to believe anything else.
Have they mistreated you?
No. I believe they are saving that part for my execution. 3 days from now.
It won't come to that. We'll get you out of here.
In 2 days, the daughter of the pharaoh will wed. Most of the guards will be needed to control the crowds.
And who is this young Minister of War?
This is Marib. You remember Hinu's boy.
Hinu. Your father was a great warrior. He had hopes you would grow up to be a scholar.
Sire, the chief jailer will attend Amneris' wedding. They've assigned a lowly guard to take his place, a man I know.
You are suggesting you may be able to bribe this guard?
Let's just say we've done business in the past.
That would take a lot of gold.
I have it. For years I've been stealing from the palace. I thought someday I could use it to get back home to Nubia. What if I can send my king home?
We will all be going home soon, Marib. Now, how are the docks guarded?
By the captain's soldiers.
So the odds are slim. Can you use a sword, boy?
Me? Actually, I'm better at providing encouragement from the sidelines.
A fight won't be necessary. They'll let us through.
Captain Radames gave you that?
Who is this captain? An Egyptian?
Yes, but he's not like the others, father.
He leads Pharaoh's army, yet he did not lay waste to our country like the others?
He regrets his past.
Aida! Do not shame yourself and me with such witless sentiment. Do not tell me this Egyptian mourns for the Nubian men executed, the women ravaged, and the children taken into slavery. Any soft look you have given this captain, any soft word, betrays the innocents who have suffered at his hands and at the hands of every soldier he commands. You will cut this man from your heart.
Yes, father.
I would not have thought it possible that these Egyptians will give me one more reason to hate them.
This is the moment where the gods expect me to beg for help. But I won't even try. I want nothing in the world but myself to protect me. And I won't lie down, roll over and die. All I have to do is forget how much I love him. All I have to do is put my longing to one side. Tell myself that love's a never-changing situation. Passion would have cooled, and all the magic would have died. It's easy, so easy. All I have to do is pretend I never knew him. On those very rare occasions when he steals into my heart, better to have lost him when the ties are barely binding. Better the contempt of the familiar cannot start. About him as he was when I last touched him, and how he would have been were I to be with him today. Those very rare occasions, don't let up, they keep on coming. All I ever wanted, and I'm throwing it away. It's of a war-defeated people, a father and a nation who won't let a coward run. Is this how the gods reward the faithful through the ages, forcing us to prove that all the hardest things we've done are easy, so easy. Rising around me, and though I choose to leave him for another kind of love, this is no denial, no betrayal, but redemption. Redeemed in my own eyes, and in the pantheon above. It's easy.
Thank you.
why did we invade Babylon?
Because once we control the waterways, the whole world opens up to us.
Yes. But our Egyptian armies just stormed in and seized power. How oppressive of us!
Perhaps, princess. But where do you think that beautiful necklace came from?
Suddenly it's not so beautiful.
You summoned me, father? Princess?
Yes, yes. I was just explaining our foreign campaigns to Amneris.
Really?
Yes, yes. Because you wanted to know what's been preoccupying you of late.
Radames. I feel like we haven't had a moment alone together since you returned from Nubia. I miss you. Can't we spend the afternoon together?
Of course. Of course we can. But first, I'd like to have a word with my father. Here. You can read this while you wait.
The campaign at Kadesh!
It will give us something to talk about.
I didn't realize we're at a loss for topics. But then again, there's a lot I haven't realized.
Well, that was clever of you.
I can't have you neglecting the girl. Not after all the trouble I've gone through.
You arranged a marriage.
There have been other arrangements as well, son. Things I've done on your behalf.
I haven't asked you to do anything for me.
Yes, because you've been too busy whiling away the hours with that slave girl.
Oh, your spies are good.
Radames, you can have your little diversions. Just wait until after you've wed.
What? Like you did?
Don't you realize this slave could cost you the throne?
I don't care about the throne, father. I'm not like you. And I never will be.
Don't come on so cocksure, boy. You can't escape your genes. No point in feeling pure, boy. Your background intervenes. Now listen good and listen straight. You're not the master of your fate. Must be reconciled. You'll always be your father's child. At times reclaimed, at times reviled, you wind up doing just what I'd have done. Like father, like son.
Don't assume your vices get handed down the line, that a parent's blood suffices to condemn the child's design. I've done wrong, I can't deny, but at least I know that I shouldn't blame that on my stock. Hey, this may come as quite a shock, but I'm no chip off any block. I wouldn't wish those words on anyone. Like father, like son.
Do you really want to throw away your future? All for some wretched slave!
She has a name!
In a few months, you won't even be able to remember her name!
You can forget about your plans, father. There will be no wedding.
He's lost all sense of reason. And why some foreign slut? Not only is that treason, some doors are slamming shut. Just like me, he's found that bliss. Can't excite, but will enmesh. Once we rid him of this plight, once that harlot's out of sight, then I think he'll see the light. He won't walk back to daddy, he will run like father, like son. Like father, like son. Like father, like son. Like father, like son! Find the slave girl called Aida. And when you do, kill her.
Thank you. sorry for everything I've said and for anything that I forgot to say to. When things get so complicated, I stumble at best, muddle through. I wish that our lives could be simple. I don't want the world, only you. Oh, I wish I could tell you this face to face, but there's never the time, never the place. So this letter will have to do. I love you.
Tomorrow, princess, you and your father will be free.
We will live to tell our grandchildren of the king's great escape.
Nubia will prevail!
Quiet!
We are here for Aida. Which one is she?
I am Aida.
Forgive us, princess, but you cannot be sacrificed. Every person here is willing to risk their lives for Nubia.
Where are you going? You're going to meet him, aren't you?
Merib, I do not ask you to understand. I do not understand. I must see him. But I do. I have to see him.
No, no. You cannot give yourself to him. The Egyptians have taken enough from us already. You are our princess, our inspiration, our promise of a new day.
I'm sorry, Merib.
There is a time, there is a place, when love should conquer all. The rest of life is pushed aside as truth and reason fall. But only if that selfishness can lead to something good. I thought I knew you, princess, but I never understood. I don't know you, I don't know you.
Aida, I thought you were...
They came for me, but they took another. I blame myself.
No. No, I put you in danger. But I promise, it will never happen again. I'm going to build you a house at the border of our countries, and we will sail the Nile.
Oh, Radames, you can't. You can't call off the wedding.
Yes, yes, I can. And I will.
I love you, Radames, but you must marry the princess tomorrow. Tomorrow. What you want for us is impossible. It is a foolish plan. They would hunt us down.
No. No, I can find a way for us to be together.
I am here to tell you we can never meet again. Simple, really, isn't it? A word or two and then a lifetime of not knowing where, how, or why, or when. You think of me, or speak of me, or wonder what befell that someone you once loved so long ago so well.
Never wonder what I feel as living shuffles by. You don't have to ask me, and I need not reply. Moment of my life from now until I die, I will think or dream of you, and fail to understand how a perfect love can be confounded out of hand. Is it written in the stars? Are we paying for some crime? Is that all that we are good for? Just some stretch of mortal time? Or some God's experiment in which we have no say, in which we're given paradise, but only for a day?
Marry the princess, Radames. You can help my people. This could be our chance to do something important, don't you see? It may be the whole reason we met.
Then it would be a cruel trick.
Not if the gods put us together for some greater purpose.
Nothing can be altered. There is nothing to decide. No escape, no change of heart, nor any place to hide.
You are all I ever want. But this I am denied. Sometimes in my darkest thoughts, I wish I never learned what it is to be in love and have that love returned.
Is it written in the stars? Are we paying for some crime? Is that all that we are good for? Just a stretch of mortal time?
Or some God's experiment in which we have no say, in which we're given paradise, but only for a day?
I will do what you ask of me, but you must also do something for me. Go home. Leave Egypt forever.
What are you saying?
While I'm taking my wedding vows, there will be a boat waiting for you at the docks to return you to Nubia. At least I will have a measure of happiness knowing that you are free.
How have I come to this? How did I slip and fall? How did I throw half a lifetime away without any thought at all? This should have been my time. It's over, it never began. I close my eyes to so much for so long, and I no longer can. I try to blame it on fortune, some kind of shift in a star. But I know the truth, and it haunts me. It's blown just a little too far. To go on with the rest of my life, to pretend I don't care. This should have been my time. It's over, it never began. I close my eyes to so much for so long, and I no longer can. I try to blame it on fortune, some kind of twist in my fate, but I know the truth.
As witnessed by the gods and all of Egypt, I pronounce you man and wife. May your lives be forever filled with the joy of this moment.
Your Majesty! The Nubian king has escaped!
Radames, call your men to arms.
Fan out across the city.
The fastest route to Nubia is by water. Send a regime to search the docks.
No! Seal off the docks.
But we can't.
No one shall reach the pier before I arrive there.
Princess, we must hurry! They've sounded the alarm!
Radames!
Aida, the boat is here!
Forgive me, father, but I need love one last moment with him!
Daughter!
Of course. You're the Nubian princess. You had me marry Amneris just so your king could escape. What a fool I am. It was all a lie, an act. Every word, every kiss.
No, but I have made too many mistakes and too many people have suffered. I could not act selfishly now.
So you lied to me.
Not when I said I love you. Say you believe me!
She's alive.
Stop there!
Aida, come!
Aida, go to the boat. This is your last chance.
Now it's not Mab!
Step aside, boy.
Mab!
Radames, for the love of Egypt, stop there.
No! My soldiers are almost here.
No!
Aida!
Go now or Nubia will have no king.
Radames, what have you done?
It's all over, father. When they come for me, they'll take you away too.
No, that can't happen. Egypt needs me.
You're the one who tied our fates together, remember? Like father, like son. I think you should go.
Radames!
Princess, forgive me. I failed you.
No, Merib, you inspired me.
I wanted to go back to Nubia. Aida, take me home.
Amneris, I never meant to hurt you.
Radames, if you deny everything, there is a chance. My father might spare your life. Listen to me! They want to bury you alive.
Yes. That's what we do to traitors.
But you must say that everyone is wrong.
No. I can't. Aida is everything that I thought I was meant to be. But her courage and her love for her people have put me to shame. Every act of my life has been wrong. Except for this.
Did you ever love me at all?
Amneris, I have loved you my whole life.
Take your hands off her! After all, she is a princess. Amneris, there were so many times I wanted to tell you everything, but I couldn't. No wonder you understood me so well. Amneris, you must believe me. I am to blame for what has happened, not Radames. Amneris, let him live. Amneris, let him live. I can't. Yes, you can. You love him. Don't you love him? Aida, I love you both.
Amneris, let us begin. Bring forth the prisoners. Zozer has been apprehended, and we have uncovered his plot. Radames, I chose you. I trusted your father. Now I will make things right while I still can. The prisoners will receive their sentences.
Father,
I have a request.
A request?
I know the traitors must die for their crimes against Egypt. That is the law, but I would ask that they be allowed to die together.
But that would be mercy. After they disgrace you in front of the entire nation.
I was wronged. It should be my decision.
You don't know your own mind. For their crimes.
Your Majesty, you have poison in your blood. We both know this. Soon I will be completely alone because everyone I love will be gone. So you must allow me to exercise my will over Egypt. Because I am your successor. And because I demand it. For their crimes, the traitors will be buried beneath the sands of Egypt in one tomb together. The daughter of Isis has spoken.
Such elaborate lives, wild ambitions in our sights, an affair of the heart survives days apart. Hurried nights seems quite unbelievable to me. I don't want to live like that. Seems quite unbelievable to me. I don't want to love like that. I just want a time to be.
Dark.
Give me your hands, Aida. I'm right here with you. There's another world waiting for us. I can feel it. The way I always knew there was a world beyond every bend of the Nile, just waiting to be discovered.
You will find me in that world?
If I have to search for 100 lifetimes, I will find you again. There'd be no ties of time and space to bind us.
And all horizon we could not pursue.
We'd leave
leave the world's misfortunes far behind us. And I will put my faith and trust in you.
A gentle light still shone, showing me my path as I ascended to the throne. Certain in my heart that ancient wars must cease, a lover's death gave birth to a reign of peace. And their story and my journey and the lessons they provide draw their strength and inspiration from a love that never